I'm building a dipole antenna to use on 2 meters. We'll find out if it works today or not on this episode of KF5IRE Ham Radio. Yes, I am building a dipole to use on the 2 meter band today in this video. And basically the concept in a nutshell, it's just the same thing as the 10 meter dipole that I built in I think my first or second video on this channel, and my Christmas light dipole antenna that I built as well. I think I'll end up building a new main body of the antenna as well. So let's head over there to the workbench and let's get started building. All right, so first things first, I just wanna talk about some of the supplies that I'm gonna be using to make this antenna. So what you're looking at here is an overhead shot of my workbench. And as you can see here, basically I just have this leftover wire from making my Christmas light antennas from this year. And this is what I'm gonna be using to make the radiating element of the dipole. And as you can see here, I've got these screws, which are gonna be holding this SO239 connector to this piece of plastic here, which is a piece of cutting board that I bought from Walmart. This is what's gonna be the main body of the dipole itself. I'm going to solder one of the pieces of the wire into the SO239, and the other leg of it is going to get connected to one of the corners. And then these stakes here that I have, these are just to stake the antenna out once I get it set up in the backyard. These terminal rings, and this again is what's gonna go onto one of these screws on one of the corners of the SO239 connector. So I'm gonna go ahead and set everything aside that I'm not using right now. So what I'm gonna do first is I'm gonna cut this wire to length, and I'm gonna be doing about 3.6 inches of wire for the antenna because that is a quarter wave of 2 meters. 1 foot. Feet. Three feet and 6 inches. All right. This is 3 foot 6 inches. So now what I'm going to do is I'm just gonna pull this out. I'm not gonna measure this one because it should be the same length. I've already measured it. Let's go ahead and cut that. All right, so I now have both legs of my dipole cut. These are the legs of the dipole, so I'm gonna go ahead and start prepping them now. So now that these are both cut, I'm going to start by terminating them. And I'm just gonna cut about maybe about a quarter of an inch off there. About a quarter of an inch on this one. Doesn't look like I shorted them at all. So like I said, just strip that back. That's all I need to do on this one. Same thing on the other leg here. Strip off about maybe a quarter of an inch. About, I think right there is good. So both of these are now cut to length and now stripped. First thing I'm gonna do here is I'm gonna actually just solder the wire into this here. What I actually need to do first is I need to tin this. So start by tinning the end. All right, so what I'm gonna do here, set the helping hands to hold the wire in place. Not my best soldering job, but I think it'll work. Kind of the same thing here with the other side. I'm just gonna tin it real quick. We're gonna just crimp this and then I think we're good. All right, that is nice and crimped in there. And one more thing I'm gonna do here, just kind of solder it to the plate on the terminal ring. And then I think we're done soldering after that. I think we're about good there. So I'm happy with that. Now that I have both ends of the dipole now terminated. I've got the SO239 and the terminal ring now terminated. I'm going to now make the main body of the dipole itself. And again, to make this, basically I'm gonna do kind of the same style that I did with my 10 meter dipole and my Christmas lights dipole, where I just kind of make like a kind of just this weird kind of like T shape basically. That kind of works best for me, so that's what I'm going to make. But I think this time I'm gonna make it actually a little bit smaller. I don't wanna make it too terribly big, so we'll go 3 inches in, about an inch high, I think is what we're at. Close to an inch high, yeah, so about an inch high. And then we'll go up about an inch, and then go back over. I think I did about 3 inches, so I'll do about 2 here, back down, and another 3. All right, so that is not at all a straight line, but I think it will work just fine. So now I'm just gonna kind of cut it out and get moving on it. Going to be kind of where the hole goes up here at the top, and then the SO239 is going to go kind of here in the middle, and then just strain release here on the side, and that's just about it. That is good enough right there. So that's how we do that. All right, there's the first hole. All right, number 2's done. I'm only gonna put 2 screws on this one. I don't really think I need more than 2. Go ahead and draw up my strain release now. So I got that side done, and this one is actually going to be this side. So we'll go ahead and just feed this one through. All right, so we've got one side of our dipole done now. So let's go ahead and finish up the other side, and then we'll be ready to give it a continuity test and then maybe go try to get on the air with it. Now I can go ahead and just screw it down to the cutting board and we'll be good to go. And I'll just fasten this down. So it should be secure. I'm gonna go ahead and finish feeding the strain release through real quick. And there we go. This is it. This is our 2 meter dipole. This has probably gotta be the ugliest thing I've ever made in my entire life, I think. I mean, I did not do this pretty at all. It's not the most symmetric thing. I mean, the SO239 connector is crooked, but I'll be honest, it's probably gonna work. So yeah, we're gonna test it out now. I'm gonna continuity test it real quick, make sure it checks out all good. No beep. Beep is not good. No beep is good. All right, so it continuity tested all good, and everything's all terminated, everything's all screwed down. Like I said, I'm not really gonna worry about screwing anything else down. Oh, I do need to drill my top hole to hold it up. But one thing I did forget to make was insulators. So what I'm gonna do to make insulators is, all I'm gonna do here is I'm just gonna kind of fold it over and zip tie it at the ends. Not the best way to do that, but it's the way I am doing it this time, just because I'm kind of lazy and I'm ready to get this thing up on the air. So now we have both of our legs there. I just got these kind of zip tied. Like I said, I'm gonna throw some paracord on the ends of it to pull it outward. And then here at the top, just run a zip tie through the top here so that I can hang it with some paracord as well. All right, there we go. Got a nice loop there. So yeah, that's my completed dipole. Again, this is not pretty by any means whatsoever. Just something I wanted to try out. I think what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go hang this up in a tree and we'll go put it on the SWR meter and try to make a couple contacts on it. All right, and it's all hung up now. That's it up there. I don't know if you can really see it in the video, but yeah, it's up there in the, a little bit off the ground. I couldn't get as high nearly as I wanted it to be, but yeah, it'll work for this. The legs are spread out in kind of an inverted V, so we'll get it put up on the Nano V&A and we'll see what it ends up looking like SWR wise. All right, so we're back inside now and I just got done hooking the antenna up to the Nano V&A and I'm actually kind of surprised at what I see, because as you guys can see on there, it's showing I'm SWR of 4 or greater all the way through 2 meters. So I was hoping I was gonna have resonance on at least some portion of 2 meters, but yeah, that does not look very good. So I don't know if maybe I miscalibrated the Nano V&A or something like that, or I don't know, but I'm still gonna go ahead and try this antenna out anyways, because I'm gonna be using it on my Radiodity DB25D. Keep in mind, I don't have a tuner for this antenna, so I have no clue if this is actually gonna work or not. Maybe we'll be able to reel in a contact, maybe we won't, and this whole video will just be a complete failure and you guys get to watch me fail. I'm gonna go ahead and get it hooked up to the DB25 and let's see if we can make contact or not. All right, so before I got on here, I actually was able to make one contact with it on a repeater up in Denton, which is about 30 to 40 miles away from me. So I guess it actually does work. He said that he was able to hear me audibly. I don't know if my microphone saved the audio or not. I'm gonna try to pull it. But yeah, right before I got on here, that happened, so it works. W5NGU. So yeah, you can hear the repeater there. So I'm gonna try to see if maybe I can make a quick contact on a 2 meter simplex. I don't know if anybody's out there listening or not. It's about 7 o'clock PM right here. So yeah, let's just kind of scan around and see what we can get into with this antenna. This is Kilo India 5, India Romeo Echo. Is there anybody out there listening on 146.52? There may just actually be nobody listening on 2 meter call. And just so you guys know too, this is only a 25 watt mobile. This is the DB25D, little mini mobile, but like I said, it was able to get into about 40 miles away from me. I didn't hear anybody call back to me on there. So let's jump around a little bit, see if there's anything else that I can try it on. This is Kilo India 5, India Romeo Echo. Is there anybody listening that can give me a radio check? So I think I'm hitting the repeater because it comes back at me when I unkey, when I called out, but I don't know that anybody's listening now. So this thing receives pretty good. This is a city that's about 2 miles away. I think the repeater's 2 to 3 miles away. KI5 IRE Chase in Bedford.
I think I copied correctly, see if I did. KI5 IRE, that's Kilo India 5 India Romeo Echo, is that correct?
That is correct, sir.
Chase, made the trip. Thank you very much for coming back with that. And the repeat got you in. I believe that was no traffic as well.
No traffic. Well, I made it into this net, which is not very impressive because it's only about 2 miles away, but The antenna at least works. So I was able, like I said, to make a contact about 40 miles away up on a repeater in Denton, and now this one on the Hurst repeater, which is about 2 to 3 miles away from me. Well, I would say that this project was a success. You guys did not get to watch me fail today. I did not blow up the radio, and I was able to make a contact with somebody on a repeater about 40 miles away. Like I said, I didn't end up catching that one on video, and was able to check into that net. So the antenna works. It's probably not the most efficient. Like I said, the SWR showed up like the lowest on the nano VNA that I saw was like 4. So I'm not sure if that has to do with the resistance from using the Christmas lights wire instead of something like speaker wire, or really what the deal is there. But like I said, I think this is a success. Hopefully I'll be able to make some simplex contacts here at some point. I just don't know if there's anybody on there or if I'm not being heard. I couldn't find an SDR to check that with tonight. So I think it was a success in my book. What do you guys think about this antenna project? Let me down in the comments below. Honestly, I don't know if this is really a good antenna or not. I just thought it was a cool project. I kind of had the idea to make a dipole for 2 meters out of thin air, honestly. And I just thought it'd be cool to make a video about it and just kind of see what you guys had to say about it. Maybe you guys have some tips for me. Maybe I did something in a way that you think I should probably try a different way or something along those lines. Either way, I had a ton of fun making this antenna, doing this project, getting it hung up in the tree, and then testing it out. And if you have not already, make sure to hit that like button, hit that subscribe button. Those two things just help out the channel, helps this video reach more people, and helps the channel continue to grow. And also, make sure to hit that notification bell so you get notified when I upload new videos. And as always, guys, thank you again so much for watching. Until next time, 73.